In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the love of God, which goes beyond all understanding, may He console our hearts this night, allow us to enter into a time of friendship and fellowship with those who come, and to know that He is here with you. We have our Father Cijo, our pastor, our ladies of our Catholic ministry, like we express to you our deepest sorrow and sympathies to you at the loss of Patricia. It's hard to say goodbye to a friend. I've known Pat for almost 50 years. And I keep thinking we should just all live forever, but that doesn't happen. And with the struggles of cancer, this is, I think, a great mercy. So our sympathies to you.
Okay, we the members of the Catholic Women's League of Holy Name of Jesus Parish are gathered here today to commend our deceased sister, Pat, to God. We recall in silence her loving service to others and pray that God will welcome her into eternal glory. Loving God, you promised fullness of joy to those who seek your face. Trusting in your word, we pray to you for our sister, Pat, who sought to further your reign on earth by her service in the Catholic Women's League for God in Canada. Though we are saddened that she is no longer with us, we entrust her to you with confidence. May she now live in peace, joy, and happiness. We ask this in the name of Jesus, who is God. Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
On arriving at Bethany, Jesus found that Lazarus had been in the tomb for 4 days already. And Bethany is only about 2 miles from Jerusalem, and many Jews had come to Martha and Mary to sympathize with them over their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus had come, she went out to meet him. Mary remained sitting in the house. Martha said to Jesus, "If you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know now that even now, whatever you ask of God, He will grant to you." "Your brothers," said Jesus to her, "will rise again." Martha said, "I know He will rise again at the resurrection on the last day." And Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. And do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," she said, "I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who has come into this world." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You can imagine how it was for Jesus. Scriptures will tell us that when he found out that Lazarus died, he decided to stay 2 more days where they were. How difficult that would have been for a friend just not to go immediately. But that wasn't going to be God's plan for Lazarus and for Martha and Mary. Because he had to show the world, he has to show us, that the resurrection of the dead is real. Now, he could have saved Pat. In the blink of an eye, he could have saved it. He could save each and every one of us. But somewhere along the line, each and every one of us is heading out of here. That's just the reality. We're here for a time. And, you know, and how we make of that time, you know, is our legacy. And Pat had a great legacy of faith, great legacy as a mother, husband, wife, great legacy to grandchildren, and I gathered that to brothers, those all who were present. Both Father Paul and I were very touched when we were there a couple days ago. The level of love they had for your grandmother, your wife, your sisters, and how you were there helping her to leave, stroking her hands, touching her hair, those tender things that you'll never forget, you'll always remember where you were the day your grandma passed away. But we remember that. And you'll always remember the dignity of which she left this world in. And that's the most important aspect of our life. Because our faith really gets to the rubber of the road when we're ready to exit. And it's how gracefully we leave really shows who we are and how our faith is. And I've known Pat a long time. I've known her as a woman of faith. Her faith was always a faith that was in action, always a faith and trust that God had an eternal plan. Even from the moment of time, from Crohn's all the way through, years and years of suffering, wore it bravely, trusting Jesus in everything, and he has not disappointed her. As I'm sure you know, that those words as she was leaving were, "Well done, good and faithful servant." And we trust in those words. We trust in those words that God has prepared a place for her, and there she is now.
Please join us in reciting the Decorative Beads.
Our Father, who art
in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Gracious and loving God, in your mercy you have chosen us in Christ to be part of your family. In Christ's name we pray for our deceased sister Pat, for the church and the world. We pray for our sister Pat, who was baptized into everlasting life. Receive her now in your eternal embrace. Hear our prayer. Give strength to her family and friends who mourn. Help us to bear the burden of sorrow in a spirit of faith and hope.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for all our deceased members who have died in faith. May they be raised up on the last day.
Hear our prayer.
Creator God, hear our prayers. Welcome our sister into paradise and strengthen our hope that we will share in the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen.
May our sister Pat, who adopted Our Lady of Good Counsel as her patroness through League activities, rest in peace through the mercy of God.
Amen.
May God bless us all through Jesus our Redeemer and in the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Blessed are those who have died in the Lord. Let their rest and their labors for their good deeds go with them. Eternal rest grant unto Patricia, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace.
Amen.
And may her soul, the souls of all the faithful departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. May God, the Father of all mercies, bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This concludes our prayers. Again, it's an honor to be here and to be here with you today.
Oh, confesses that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Pat, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice and rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated, everyone. I invite the Lord and will make you Pat's brother for our first reading.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim the liberty to the captives, and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor, and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, all who are led by the Spirit of God are sons and daughters of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption to sponsorship. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, they're heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. If in fact we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing comparing with the glory about to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not of its own will, but by the will of the one who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be set free from its long bondage to decay and will obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God. We know what the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now. And not only the creation, but we ourselves, who are the first fruits of the Spirit, grown inwardly while we wait for adoption to sponsorship, the redemption of our bodies. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
She had left her mark on me as well. In the second reading from St. Paul to the Romans chosen by the family, St. Paul writes that all who are led by the Spirit of God are sons and daughters of God, and that this Spirit is not a spirit of slavery, it's not a spirit of fear, but rather a spirit of adoption as children of God. And he goes on to say, if we are children, then we are heirs to the kingdom of heaven with Jesus. This sonship, this daughtership is a great gift, and it's a great mystery of our Catholic Christian faith. And it is something that God embraced to the very end. I was very blessed to celebrate God's sacrament of anointing the sick with Pat, and as many of the family members were present at that time, I think we could all sense that there was no spirit of fear, but rather the complete opposite. There was a sense of peace, spirit of thanksgiving to God for her family, for her 66 years of marriage with Jim, for her tremendous faith and all the blessings that she had received in her life. Even as a rookie priest and in my third year of priesthood, I've been around a lot of people who are nearing their death. And it is not often that we see this kind of sense of peace or calm. We often read accounts of the saints that when nearing their own death, they were at peace because they saw death merely as a doorway to see the beautiful face of our Lord. Death for them was merely a step towards seeing their Abba Father because they had really recognized and understood their identity as sons and daughters of God. Pat often prayed to her Abba Father, as I'm told, often addressing her father as Abba, Daddy. And God clearly gifted Pat with this deep sense of her identity as a daughter of God and being faithful to our God until the very end. We're all reminded of the spirit of adoption given to us at baptism, reminding us that even in life and death, we are sons and daughters, which is why, you know, this morning I had baptism at St. Mary's Church. We have these very symbolic things as well. The white garment that our infants are clothed in, and the white garment that covers the casket at each and every funeral mass around the world, reminding us that even in death, our Lord claims us as his sons and daughters. And even at every baptism in any Catholic church, we have the Easter candle, the pastor candle, reminding us that the light of Christ shines through. Even in death, we know that our Lord, in his own death and resurrection, paved for us a new way and a new life for people of faith. As our prophet Isaiah tells us in our first reading, that the Spirit of the Lord God anoints us to give us the oil of gladness instead of mourning, to give us the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. And we know that this daughter of God was truly anointed, even for her last moments, to give thanks to God for her family, to express her love for you, to give praise to God. What a tremendous witness of faith that is to us. At least that was one of the things that I walked away with. I know Deacon Gary and myself were very blessed to have visited with Pat and her family on the last day that she shared with us on this earth. And he spoke about, and myself, how we're both deeply moved by the love the family showed, clearly for your grandma, your great-grandma, especially the grandchildren, great-grandchildren. It's very powerful to see your love for her. And when we all lay our hands and implore the Holy Spirit to bless her, to anoint her, she was just praising the Lord. Just a beautiful thing. And on her very last moment, her last days, this last day on earth, she was able to receive Holy Communion one last time here on earth. It was a great gift. And you can't really plan these types of things. That the Lord really blessed her, her faithfulness, and finally, a few hours later, after receiving the Eucharist in Jesus Christ, she breathed her last breath. We know, brothers and sisters, that this is a great consolation, a great affirmation that the Holy Spirit was truly moving powerfully in these last days. First, she was able to come back to Mass. That's been a great cross for people of faith when we close our doors for safety and so on and so forth. But even when we opened up, we're very fortunate to have her come back recently to attend Mass once again. And of course, as I mentioned, to receive Holy Communion along with her family. And every member of the family received Eucharist that afternoon as well. And I'm told that you as a family prayed the Holy Rosary together for her. And it's a really tremendous blessing and witness for all of us. There's no question that our sister in Christ had tremendous faith, and as a people of faith, we know that we are to hope, that in death we know life has changed and not ended. But nonetheless, we know it is still difficult to lose someone we love dearly. But I think we can draw strength and hope from what gave Pat strength and her life. First, the Word of God. And in her involvement with the sharers of the Word, I saw her prayer room, pretty hardcore prayer room there. You know, all those pictures of the saints, the Magna Carta, the Sacred Heart, the kneeler, no cushion on the kneeler, it's a really, really powerful thing to see to all those pictures of those who have died, family and friends that her and Jim would dedicate their time to pray for family and friends. It's a great witness that she felt she drew strength from praying for others. Some people are blessed with that, the gift of intercessory prayer, and also her strength from the Word of God, that Word of God that continues to inspire humans throughout our history. Thirdly, of course, drawing strength and hope from her family. No question about that. And so, brothers and sisters, when you're feeling down in the future, because we all know that it's hard to lose someone we love dearly, please know and be comforted by the same things that comforted her. Because the Word of God, the Bible, sometimes these things contain our whole life. And maybe I don't know if she's one who highlights or underlines or anything like that, but to know that somehow, at some point in her life, this passage touched her in some way. And to have that same strength, knowing that what strengthened her will continue to strengthen us, and of course, coming together as a family, as we did with her, to continue to do that once in a while, to come together, pray the rosary, and entrust all your cares and your sorrows to our Lord. Just as an FYI, as I was praying about this homily, today is an optional memorial of a saint, St. Anthony Mary Claret. Kind of an unknown saint, but when I looked him up, he has a great devotion to Mother Mary as well, that he had founded the missionary son to the Magna Carta Mary. He also founded the Sisters of Mary Magdalene, dedicating all of his whole ministry through the Magna Carta. And I just thought it was another sign that the Holy Spirit continues to work to offer us gifts and affirmations that the Holy Spirit, our Blessed Mother, is at work. So brothers and sisters, as we gather together as a people of faith, we bring all of our memories, everything that we cherish with Pat, your grandma, your great-grandma. We entrust to the Lord all the wonderful joys, all the challenging times, and we entrust it to our Heavenly Father. We give thanks to God today for the example of love, 66 years of married love with Jan, the 70 years they were together, with all the love that Pat imparted to us. And we entrust her soul to the mercy of our loving Savior, to the prayers of St. Anthony Mary Claret, St. John, St. Clement, and of course to our Blessed Mother, that they may assist our sister into her eternal dwelling place forever. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and that perpetual life shall be her. May she rest in peace.
Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our sister Patricia was nourished at the feet of the Savior, welcome into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, hear our mercy.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and family members have gone before us on the way to the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love and gather into an eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather the people to yourself, so that from the rise of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, to graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you.
Seeing you are God as you are, Thank you. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope that one day we shall joyfully greet her again, and the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In baptism, Tricia shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. May she be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. As a sign of respect for our sister, we let this incense rise to God, who has called her to share life with him forever.
Thank you.
Father of Mercies, we commend our sister Patricia in the sure and certain hope that together with all who died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. Dear friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship which you give to others be a sign of God's peace for you. In peace now, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
And we're gonna face in towards each other using two hands. We're gonna lift straight up and we're gonna gently sidestep back into the vehicle. Make sure she's good and safe. Now, once we get to the cemetery, just come right back to this one, okay?
Breathe a minute.
Take food.
So nice. And
thank you. Patricia has gone to her rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist her with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our sister, and together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. We read in St. Paul's letter to the Philippians that our citizenship is in heaven, and it is from there that we are expecting a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. O God, by whose mercy the faithful departed find rest, bless this grave. Send your holy angel to watch over it. As we bury here the body of our sister, deliver her soul from every bond of sin, that she may rejoice in you with your saints forever. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Because God has chosen to call our sister Patricia from this life to himself, we commit her body to the earth. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise up her body on the last day. We'll now offer prayers to carry on our behalf for Heavenly Father.
Dear friends, in reverence, let us pray to God, the source of all mercies. The response to these is, hear our prayer. Gracious Lord, forgive the sins of those who have died in Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Remember all the good they have done. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Welcome them, or welcome Patricia into eternal life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all those who mourn. Comfort them, Lord, in their grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lighten their sense of loss with your presence. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Increase their faith, strengthen their hope. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for ourselves on our pilgrimage through life. Keep us faithful in your service. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Kindle in our hearts longing for heaven. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us now pray the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
God of holiness and power, accept all of our prayers on behalf of your servant Patricia. Do not count her deeds against her, for in her heart she desired to do your will. As her faith united her to your people on earth, so may your mercy join her to the angels in heaven. We ask all this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Bow your heads for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord.
Let the perpetual light shine upon her.
May she rest in peace.
Amen.
And may her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless all of you gathered here, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Father. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Father in heaven, we ask your blessings on all these crucifixes, that anyone who looks at them or prays with them or in his presence may be saved by your peace, your joy, and your love. We entrust all them to the prayers of Mother Mary. The Almighty God bless these items in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Bye, guys.